could be done far better and far cheaper if it wasn't left to these absolutely inexperienced and extremely exclusive military gentlemen. They think they are leading England and showing us all how, instead of which they are just keeping us back. Why in thunder are they doing everything? Not one of them, when he is at home, is allowed to order the dinner or poke his nose into his own kitchen or check the household books. The ordinary British colonel is a helpless old gentleman. He ought to have a nurse. This is not merely the trivial grievance of my insulted stomach. It is a serious matter for the country. Sooner or later, the country may want the food that has been wasted in all these capers. In the aggregate, it must amount to a daily destruction of tons of stuff of all sorts. Tons! Suppose the war lasts longer than we reckon. From this point, Hugh's letter jumped to a general discussion of the military mind. Our officers are beastly good chaps, nearly all of them. That's where the perplexity of the whole thing comes in. If only they weren't such good chaps! If only they were like the Prussian officers to their men, then we'd just take on a revolution as well as the war and make everything tidy at once. But they are decent, they are charming. Only they do not think hard, and they do not understand that doing a job properly means doing it as directly and thought-outly as you possibly can. They won't worry about things. If their tempers were worse, perhaps their work might be better. They won't use maps or timetables or books of reference. When we move to a new place, they pick up what they can about it by hearsay. Not one of our lot has the gumption to possess a contoured map or a Michelin guide.